John Birmingham. I'm a visual artist based in Dungarvan in County Waterford in the south of Ireland. And last year I created a series of images entitled Think About the Future. And it was based on things that were going on at the time, things that were in the news, things that were happening around where I live. And in that sense, even though it was called Think About the Future, it was really about taking the things that were happening at the moment to a conceptual extreme. And the main images that I'm going to talk about today were images that formed a panel that I was awarded my associateship in photography with the Irish Photographic Federation in September last year. So the spark for the whole idea really came from one tree stump. At the time, there was a lot of talk locally and on social media and everything about trees that were being cut down in towns around the country. And there was one tree in particular, this tree stump here, that's near where I live. When I saw it, and I saw it had been cut down, and there was a man-made birdhouse had been put on it. And it was the irony of that that struck me, the idea that, you know, you cut down a tree, but you put this man-made bird feeder onto the stump. And I went out and I photographed it, and I knew I was going to use it in something, but at when I photographed it, I didn't know exactly where it was going to lead to in terms of the whole idea. So what I started thinking about was, maybe there was this character that was wandering through a sort of a dystopian world, and sort of seeing remnants of the past, or which is our present, in different places. And that's kind of where the whole idea started. So on this, I photographed this tree stump. I put a little spring, like the bird feeder is sort of popping off the tree here. So this is where the whole idea started. And I was thinking about, you know, man obviously cutting things down and clearing natural areas for man-made constructions, and the little bird feeder being put on this cut down tree was, I thought, sort of represented that. And this is the little character going through. So following on from that, I have my character here again, and in, you know, going around with goggles and a breathing mask, carrying a tank of oxygen, you know. And obviously here she's got this pop-up book with trees. So there's an area near me here where there's an oyster farm, and there's constantly tractors and stuff going over and back to the oyster cages. And so I saw these tracks one day, and I just liked the fact that it looked like there was two different tires on the tractor or the trailer. And that kind of made me think that, again, you know, things are sort of breaking down, that this, it isn't just nature that is suffering, but things are sort of, everything is sort of deteriorating, and it's kind of improvised repairs. So it's sort of a damaged future. And there was also an idea, and it's something that comes up in some of the other images as well, the idea of the things that we have here now becoming like legend or fairy tales or myth. So this image here, again, following the character that's kind of journeying through this dystopic future. The previous summer, I'd heard someone say, oh, I'd love to go for a few cans on the beach. And I just, for some reason, the phrase kind of stuck with me. And with this, I was kind of imagining that in the future, the few cans on the beach would be cans of oxygen. Obviously, there's industrial pollution going on here in the background, and our subject hanging out. One of the things, obviously, that was in the news an awful lot was to do with plastic pollution. And one of the things I was thinking about was stuff like plastic contamination in food, and that we were consuming pieces of plastic, microplastics, and things like that. And in this, the baby is meant to represent a certain kind of naivety, in the sense that, we were consuming this stuff and we didn't know we were ingesting plastic, and there was plastic getting into the oceans and into fish. And also, the baby is born into this world that's permeated by plastic pollution. And one of the things that I was trying to do was make sure that the baby didn't look like it was in distress in any way. The idea is that the baby has been born into this and is oblivious to the state of the world that it's been born into. One of the things that I was doing with the panel was I had sister images, so some of the images were connected thematically. So in this one, it's a globe, and obviously it's like a plastic bag, and we've got lots of rubbish, and the subjects are, drowning and suffocating in the plastic pollution. Another thing that was in the news at the time was the sharing of people's information and personal data. So I had an idea for an image called Data Harvest. And what I wanted to do with this was to reference a painting called The Angelus by Jean-François Millet, because I wanted to sort of give the idea of the harvest. And in this, the two characters have stopped. There's a church here in the background, and the idea is that they've stopped because the Angelus is ringing out, and they've got their crops here in their basket. And in my image, I created a field of USB ports, and in the background here, instead of a church, I have these communications masts, and the idea being that they're out here harvesting data. So, they've got their wheelbarrow here with their USB stick, and their basket is full of ones and zeros, like binary information. So again, here, this is like a sister image to the data harvest image, and with a slightly religious connotation, in the sense that I'm taking the idea of the maypole. But on this, instead of dancing around the maypole with ribbons, we've got these children. They're all connected with their smartphones to a pole with USB ports, and they're dancing around it. And again, in the background here, the idea of sort of communication masts. This image, A Pail of Air, was partly inspired by the title of a short science fiction story by Fritz Lieber. And in the story, there's a family that are living underground, and they have to go and they collect ice to bring down and melt in order to get breathable air. So what I did in this one is, I've got this bell jar here, and I photographed this old busted up petrol pump. And we have our characters, is the idea is that she's filling her oxygen tank from the tree here in the bell jar. And you can see there's a father and child carrying theirs away. And what I was trying to suggest there was that, like, this is like the new normal for the people in this dystopia. And again, I've got these communication masts dotted throughout the landscape. So this image again, it's the title is kind of a play on like an airplane flight recorder or like a record of flight, and the idea again came from, you know, the whole idea that these 5G masks were having an impact on birds where they were put up. So in this, we've got we've got our archaeologist of the future, obviously using a smartphone, and is scanning the skeleton of a bird and is getting a holographic representation of what the bird was and what it used to do. In this image, I was just again, you know, they're in a wasteland, and you know, I was thinking about, I've been reading that drones were going to be used for things like deliveries, and I was just sort of imagining that at some point in the future, you know, will there be a bunch of drones just flying around in the sky, and again, it'll just, you know, become the norm. And obviously, you know, with things like bees and insects and stuff dying out, I just had the idea of having children out playing with nets, but instead of trying to catch butterflies, they're chasing these drones that are flying around. So in Time and Tide, I wanted to represent, you know, sea life in a single image. And also I wanted to give the idea that these things that could die out and that could disappear would become as myth, like fairy tales or folklore. So I have a mermaid representing sea life, and in here I have her caught up in, you know, tangled in ropes and stuff, like we see a lot of sea creatures tangled in man-made stuff. And I like the idea of having, you know, kids have come across this and they're kind of poking it with a stick. And down here I put in this little clock and stuck this plastic bottle on it, kind of representing like the age of plastic. So this image, the family that breathes together, it's a play on the expression the family that prays together stays together. And I had the idea of maybe, you know, it's like they're sitting around the table ready to say grace, but instead of a meal, they've got these little canisters of clean, breathable air. I didn't want to put like a crucifix on the wall, but I wanted to give, you know, some sort of hint of religion. This image, Rhapsody for Water, I was just trying to think about, you know, what scenes might look like on the street of this conceptual world that I was imagining. And so I thought about, you know, there was someone busking, but instead of getting coins or cash thrown into their bucket, you have someone actually pouring clean drinkable water. And you can see here I made this little poster. Obviously, you know, like a mobile phone contract of today, you know, all you can breathe air with your contractual obligations. Obviously, one of the things we keep hearing about is the depletion of the bee population, and I wanted to feature that in the panel. So I have some beekeepers here, and you know, their hives are kind of falling apart and they're empty, there's no bees around. And in the background, you know, we have these drones here, which is kind of a play on the idea of worker bees and drones. So I have the drones here are spraying pesticide or something, and as it turns out, this year we've seen drones used for disinfecting areas in China because of the coronavirus. The final image on the panel, what have we done? I have a guy in a suit sitting amongst all these chopped down trees, and the title is meant to be slightly ambiguous in the sense that he could be saying, what have we done? He could be saying, what have we done, in the sense that, I didn't do anything, so that, and also his expression. I mean, the idea was that, you're not really meant to know whether he's happy or sad about it. He's kind of, he's got his hat off, almost like he's mourning. But in terms of the placement of where he is on the panel, the idea I had was that he's kind of got his back to all of this, to everything else that's happening. So he's either, turned his back on it and is ignoring it, or is just oblivious to it. And so the idea was kind of, that question, because you can ask, well, what have I done? What did I do to cause it? Or you can ask, what have I done, or what am I doing to improve the situation? So that was my Think About the Future series, and thanks for listening.